Brandon God and Charles Davis ready for this Madden.
All right, everybody, here we go.
At some of the big players in today's game, and you're a big player in today's game as well.
All right. Let's get the party started. Looks like I might actually have someone who's at my overall about frickin' time. But never know their skill level, though. So let's get going here. Let's get this game started.
And here we go. The Super
All right,
Bowl
short kick.
Oh.
All right. All right.
They come up into the set eye. Now a play fake here on.
Darn it.
And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
It's a try. Wasn't much I could do there.
I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. Back to the air, Newton on second down. And it's complete.
Nice.
And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets.
There is a good pass.
Okay, when the big guy runs a corner route, you're asking a lot, no matter who's covering him, doesn't matter whether it's a linebacker or a defensive back.
All right, might have to throw this quick.
Now a first down throw for Newton. He gets this one to Mike.
Nice.
It's a gain of 9 yards, and it'll be second and about a yard. And that's one of his advantages of a passer is now with his height. Setting back there in the pocket, firing it over the middle, he can really see everything clearly.
It is, and I know that other quarterbacks get it done different ways, all right?
You don't have
his height to make a
darn
good
it.
Play. But what he does is he takes away having to make those slide steps in the pocket to find angles to throw the ball through. He just throws right over the top of it because he can see everything, and sometimes that saves time and gets the ball to a receiver quicker.
They'll try to run for it with Crowell.
Nice.
There
we go.
Well, partner, they might want to tear up your scouting reports a little bit here because they just broke tendency. Third down, you don't ordinarily see a toss. They ran it, and they ran it really well and picked up a first down. I love the way the edges were sealed, which allowed him to get to the corner.
Oh, I almost bounced out for... That was almost a freaking touchdown. Darn it.
It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a second and three.
You know what really fires up offensive linemen? When the guy that is carrying the ball behind them can create his own space and break a tackle along the way.
They'll try the air now with Newton. A little dump off for Crowell.
Ah, I screwed that up. Should have went to the left. Darn it.
They rolled out of the pocket right, and I think he wanted a little something more out of that play. Obviously, instead he hit a safety valve.
It looked like two well-coached teams there, even though there was no yardage gain, because the offensive guys, hey, they realized their quarterback was out of the pocket. All the receivers went to the right spots, tried to get in a sight line, tried to open themselves up. Just nowhere to go where they could gain yardage. How about the defensive guys, though? Did not loop.
Bingo.
Touchdown, Patriots.
Oh, yeah.
Marcus Wheaton, 30 yards. And the Pats have taken the early lead. So on third and medium, they dial up the pass, and it works to hit the end zone.
And it's really not a surprise to me. That's a throwing down in the NFL because of how tough it is to run the football. But what offenses like to do is still show run formations to make them respect it and throw out of those.
All right.
In this case,
got the lead, baby.
And made it pay off.
Spinning away.
All right. Let's see how he does on offense.
Looking left side, it's complete. And he's brought down.
Darn it.
13 yards there on the pickup. And the Falcons are going to get a first. First down and 10 now for the offensive group.
Oh, nice. Jamie Collins gave him a smack.
They were in the 4-3. Mike linebacker made a great tackle.
And when that happens, generally it means that the guys up front, the forward down defensive linemen, have absorbed all the blockers and allowed him to run free to the football. He ends up with a textbook tackle.
Wilson now off the bootleg. Fuller brings it in over the
middle.
And he's brought down. It's a pickup of 16 there, and it'll lead to a new set of downs.
In recent years, the slot receivers really gained stature in the NFL because they can do so many things. Yes, they can line up wide like your normal wide receiver, but to have that kind of courage and toughness to run routes in the middle of the field and become dependable targets for their quarterbacks and move the sticks, those guys are worth their weight in gold.
A first down carry now for Crowell.
There we go. Nice.
Alongside Charles Davis, Brandon Gordon, it's the Falcons in possession to begin quarter number two, but they face a second and long to start things out.
Oh yeah! Nicely done, baby.
And a return across midfield into the 46-yard line. So the Patriots coming out now. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were competent enough to do it on the last drive.
Oh, get out of here.
Because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing because that drive went and went. No adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
On second down, here's Crowell. Oh, he bowls over.
Oh, yeah, baby.
Now he's got some space. They got
20
yards at time.
And that's why defense coordinators always preach 11 guys to the ball. Because sometimes you have a missed tackle, but if you have a swarm of guys around, less room for him to roam even after the first missed tackle. In this case, tackle was missed. Plenty of open field to get after that.
Now a play fake here on first.
Ah!
And he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. That one will set him back nearly 10 yards here on first down of the sack.
Darn it. I kind of should have lobbed that one. Dang it.
Intended target. And they're going to be staring at a third and long here. And the offense looking to pick up the first down after the second down incompletion. Third and long. It's Newton.
Boom, baby.
And he'll take it into the end zone for a Patriot touchdown. Tommy Bohannon, 25 yards for the touchdown. And the Patriots add 6 to their lead. And it's good to make it 14-0. Now after the touchdown, it's Sturgis to send it away. Fielded about a yard deep. And he'll take this across the 25. Couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. Atlanta now coming out on the field. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive or no?
All right, let's see here.
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't
play defense at all. Oh, you got that. Really?
Attack him here. It's a gain of 5 on the play, and it'll make it a second down.
I do have to admit, I like it when it all comes together. When the top part, catching the football, right? Whether you're catching it with your hands or cradling it, comes together with the legs. In this case, the feet. Did a little toe tap. Stay in bounds and complete the catch.
And a great job by our crew on the camera shot. Love when you see the grass or on the field turf, those rubber pellets flying up. Great catch. They go play action here on first down. And he's got his man on the out.
Dang it.
And he's going to get this down to the 35-yard line. 1:58 to go in this first half of play. Back to Foxborough after this. So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve. On first and 10, it's Wilson.
Ah, oh, dang it. I was right there, too.
To the quarterback with whatever type of pressure is necessary. It's working to perfection for him today.
Second and 10, it's Wilson again.
Yay!
It's going to be incomplete. Isaiah Crowell, the intended target. And it'll be third and 10 now.
So many offenses want to include their running backs into their passing offense and be able to swing the ball out or check it down to them. But sometimes those guys are just not as comfortable catching the ball as they are running it.
So here we go now. An extra defensive back in there on third and 10. Now it's Wilson. Allen's got it over the middle.
Dang it.
First down as they bring him down at the 23. 12 yards there as they move the chains. And now the passing game here in the second quarter starting to heat up a little bit.
Don't you feel the rhythm starting to happen, right? You see it. Now the confidence is starting to rise. I think now as a play caller, because that has happened, you lean on it a little bit more. You don't go totally away from running the football, but you do say, guess what? We can throw it. We can throw it well with a whole lot of confidence. I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. But slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
Come on.
Throwing again here, Wilson. It's complete to Fuller. And he'll get it down this time to the 17. It'll be a 2-yard gain. And all of a sudden here, it's third down. Boy, the evolution of the game and how these guys in plays like that can get out of the pocket, keep plays alive. It just makes things so much harder for defenses.
It really does. And we're talking about an era in the game where the quarterbacks
nice.
Are the most athletically gifted that we've seen in a bunch. I mean, we talk about collectively, it's unbelievable.
Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime.
Figure out what play I want to pick here. Let's do this.
Field goal try here from the red zone offense out there. They'll go for it on fourth. They're going on fourth down.
Nice.
Intercepted. The linebacker Justin Duran with a pick.
Yeah, baby. Yeah. All right.
Offense now. They work their way back onto the field. And we'll see how this is played. Offensively, they've got the lead. Not a whole lot of time left. What do you think, Charles?
Well, it's tempting to try and add to your lead. But a mistake there, that could change things in a big way. I say go ahead, take the knee, get on out for the half.
All right.
Everything here, we're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime.
See if I can hit someone long here.
Now a first down throw for Newton. And Daniels has it left side. And he gets this one just
all right.
40. They'll mark him down at the 39. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. First down, Newton. With a clock showing 18 seconds now to go.
Darn it.
I wouldn't be shocked at all right now if there's a look of surprise on the big fella's face because he had the route that he wanted, run in the corner, and usually he's able to use his body and catch the football, but a really nice play by the defenders, able to knock it away.
Second down now after the incompletion. Back to the air, Newton on second down.
Ah, you jerk off.
The clock down now to 13 seconds.
God dang it. Can't believe he drops that.
Down, now they'll look to convert here on third. They'll fake the handoff. Now Newton. Going up top.
Ah!
And that'll be incomplete with just 6 seconds left on the clock.
One thing I know from experience is that when the deep ball is thrown and you're the defender, you've got to fight that little bit of panic that emerges. You've got to play the ball really well. It's a 50-50 jump ball play. And guess what? They took a shot. How are you going to win it? And in this case, they managed to get it done.
Ah!
And no one there to stop it. Hits at the 8, but it carries all the way into the end zone for a touchback. So we come upon halftime with our score 14-0. As we send you to Orlando, where we check in with Larry Ridley and our EA Sports halftime report. Take it away, Larry.
Let's keep rolling here.
We're ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number 3. Fielded about a yard deep. Then he'll take this across the 25. Couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. Now the Falcons offense gets ready to head back onto the field. They come out here with a 0 on the scoreboard. What was said in that locker room? That's what I want to know.
I would love to have been in there because we often have the feeling that there's a lot of shouting, screaming, people upset. But typically, halftime locker rooms are a lot more clinical than that. And in this case, are they upset
that
the plays weren't working because of execution? Or did they think just they were just bad plays to call?
Yeah.
We'll find out pretty quickly here if they feel like they had something going, but they just need to do it a little bit better or not.
We'll find out. Now Wilson on first down.
I caught that. Really?
11 yards on the pickup, and it'll give the Falcons a first down. So the offense has it first and 10. This is Crowell. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3.
Some runs are blocked so well, you almost forget that someone has to carry the ball to gain the yardage. The leverage by the offensive line to create space up front, really well done.
They'll run it again with Crowell.
Ah, he just barely made that.
Someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense, and guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time, but you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
Wilson now to throw on.
Oh, almost picked.
Can't hang on to it. Nearly picked. He's known for his hands defensively, but instead it just brings up 4th down. I guess they figure they got to start taking some chances. Here's a big one in this 3rd quarter as he'll go for it on 4th down. They'll go with a big back.
Yeah!
He is going to lose yardage here. He only needed a few inches, but they stop him behind the line. And the Patriots defense is going to take over on down. They begin with a run by Crowell.
Darn it, you freaking...
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held him to a gain of 2. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. 2nd and 8. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
Again, it's Crowell. And
nice.
This up past the 45 to the 47. Call it a gain of 5 that time, and they'll be left with a 3rd and about 4. And 3rd quarter here, you've got the lead. This is where that strong run game can really benefit you. Stayed in bounds there, kept the clock going.
I like all the points you just made there. And if you throw the football and it's incomplete,
Now you've stopped the clock and you've
nice.
The guys on the other side of the ball. So keep it in the hands of those runners, keep moving it, keep grinding the clock. And fits the exact right word. Over the middle, there's almost always traffic. So anytime you're a receiver in that area, you're not just focused on catching the football. You're wondering where the collision's going to come from, right? Because there's almost always someone there.
Dang, I ran freaking right into my guy. Darn it.
And even added a little extra at the end with a short run. Now that's exactly what you want on a first down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up second and five. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to out-leverage the guys up front because the offensive line is winning at the point of attack.
Here's again to Crowell.
Ah!
Fighting his way down to about the 35-yard line. Give him 4 on the carry, and it'll make this a 3rd and about 2.
On any running play that's called, they're always hoping that's going to break big and go the distance. But when you get a nice game like that, you're able to do so many things anyway. You can come back and run essentially the same play again, continue to move the ball on the ground, or you can decide to throw the ball now because usually you have the defense back on its heels.
This is Johnson. He's got it.
Nice.
Good for 15 and a first.
And they pick up a first down, and that came out of the fullback position. But as you and I both know, that doesn't necessarily mean it's a fullback playing in that spot.
You know, times have changed, right? The old school fullback doesn't really exist anymore.
He's doing up. He quit. See you later, bruh.